a teacher, she did her best. As a religious, she gave her all. We thank God that at last she has gone to meet her Lord, who has prepared a place for her where she is going to celebrate with her spouse, a place where God will wipe away the tears of everybody, a place where death will be swallowed up, a place where she will live, never to die again. Isaiah chapter 25, verse 6, verse 7 to 9, which is the first reading of this evening. We thank God for our life because as a Christian, she was baptized into the death of Christ. And because she was baptized into the death of Christ, we have the assurance that on the day of resurrection, she will rise with Christ. For those of us who are still alive, we should have it at the back of our mind that our sister has played her part. As I said earlier, it does not mean the number of years. She has done her role. She has played her role. As I was just reflecting on her life, my mind went back to when we lost one of our priests. Then I was asked to go and see the parents to break the news to the parents, the father and the mother. So I was just trying to preach to them, try to console them. The father understood with me. It was the father that was joining me to console the wife. And he told the wife that his son has completed his job. He has finished his own. The wife now asked the husband, all these people that are sitting down, is her son senior to this one? So, well, we laugh about it, but the thought is that age has nothing to do with death. It is the turn of our sister. That is why she has to go. Had it been God wanted her to live longer, God would have done it. But since this is the case, we thank God she has completed her oath. That is why those of us that are still alive, there is need for us to prepare for our death. A day we do not know. There is no need to gamble with our lives. There is no need for us to play the way with our time, believing that it will not happen. It will come a day that we never expected. Jesus Christ has made us understand. Certainly it will come. When or how, we do not know. Had it been on that day, on the 15th of March, by 6 a.m., our sister was told that you are counting the last hours for your life. Certainly, I know she would not believe because she was not sick. She was not outside. And she was not in the hospital. But today, that is the reality of life. So that is why, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, there is need for us to prepare all the time. For us to prepare, it is good to live a good life. As we see in the gospel reading of today, the church has saved all of us by giving us the sacrament of reconciliation. Whenever we are in sin, let us always try to do the confession for God to forgive us. If on the other hand, you are not able to go to confession, you don't have opportunity, we have been encouraged to have a examination of conscience and have a perfect act of contrition. Then as soon as possible, try to go to confession. This one is very necessary because if one dies in sin, believers in Christ, we need to prepare for this death that we ought to expect anytime, anywhere, anytime. Because it's appointed unto us that it's only once that we make this journey of life. Had it been that it's spare path to life, had it been that it's time for injury, I would have said yes, let us gamble with our lives. Maybe we'll have opportunity to make a change. As you see in Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27, it's appointed to everybody to die once. After that judgment. If it be this case, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, have we ever sit down to reflect at the end of our lives? Have we ever given it a thought that a day will come when we say goodbye to this mother earth? The gospel reading